Hello, everybody. This is the first day of Holy Week after the Palm Sunday yesterday, and I wanted to read a text. Every day I'm going to be producing a small meditation on a portion of the scripture, one of the events in the life of Jesus during Holy Week, that final week that led to Good Friday and then Easter Sunday. I want to read Matthew 21, 12 through 17. It goes like this. Then Jesus went into the temple and threw out all of those who were selling and buying there. He pushed over the tables used for currency exchange and the chairs of those who sold doves. He said to them, "It is written, my house will be called a house of prayer, but you have made it a hideout for crooks." People who were blind and lame came to Jesus in the temple, and he healed them. But when the chief priests and legal experts saw the amazing things he was doing and the children shouting in the temple, "Hosanna to the Son of David," they were angry. They said to Jesus, "Do you hear what these children are saying?" "Yes," he answered. "Haven't you ever read from the mouths of babies and infants you have arranged praise for yourself?" And then he left them and went out of the city to Bethany and spent the night there. Yesterday was Palm Sunday, when we celebrate Jesus' triumphal entry into Jerusalem, riding on a donkey amidst the shouts of victory and surrounded by adoring crowds. In Matthew's gospel, the parade took Jesus right to the steps of the great temple in Jerusalem, and then all hell broke loose. Jesus became angry and violent. He kicked over the chairs, overturned tables, coins splashed, bounced, and rolled all over the pavement. He sent the merchants scurrying in every direction. It was pandemonium. John's gospel said that Jesus wove a little whip and drove them out of the temple. Mark's account stated that Jesus prevented anyone from carrying any merchandise through the temple. "Stop that, you there, drop that. What are you doing? Put it down now." Jesus must have been an imposing figure. And over all the commotion and all the chaos, Jesus shouts, "It is written, my house will be called a house of prayer, but you have made it a hideout for crooks." Whoa. Jesus got mad? Where is the gentle Jesus, meek and mild? Well, that Jesus is one held mostly in our imagination, for Jesus was no Casper Milquetoast, a benign flower child who wouldn't hurt a flea. Yes, Jesus flared with anger. But for what reason? What riled Jesus up so much and motivated his actions? There are a lot of people angry today. Many people go around with a low-grade anger boiling inside, and it doesn't take much to bring it to the surface, and it erupts in vile words or even physical violence. Think of road rage. Someone unintentionally cuts into someone's lane, and they give them the finger, lay on the horn, and follow that car, riding their bumper, and when they stop at a traffic light, the guy gets out of the car wielding a baseball bat and bashes in the front windshield and the headlights. Think of the name-calling, the pushing and the shoving, and sometimes punches are thrown at a department store in a press to get some coveted item on sale that's about to be sold out. Just get on social media and read what people write and post on Facebook and Instagram or tweet. These are things that are filled with rage and insults. It's hardly safe to take a political position these days on social media without inciting a torrent of vile responses. I mean, I always thought there was more than one opinion on most issues that we could talk about. When such anger, such rage is on display, we abandon rational and civil discourse. From white supremacists marching in the streets chanting racist and anti-Semitic slogans, and terrorists plowing automobiles into crowds, and Antifa screaming vulgar insults and attacking people physically with whom they disagree, we see anger fueled by hate on display. It's sad, but some families are plagued by anger and violence as family members are subjected to being slapped, punched, and kicked and beaten. Domestic violence is horrible and it's epidemic. Well, this story that we read from the Bible today indicates that Jesus was fired with zeal and anger. But anger at what? What's the difference in his anger and the other kinds of anger? You know, anger is part of being human. Anger is an emotion that we experience when our wills are blocked, when what we wanted to happen just isn't happening, it's not going our way. People get angry. That happens, whether we want to happen or not. And if they don't control this emotion and channel it helpfully, they'll lash out. Anger can zing us up like rocket fuel, but is such anger justified in the actions that follow it? Is it okay? What are the results of human anger? Now, Jesus flared with anger when he sees injustice done. Can you stand by and watch someone cheated and belittled and humiliated? Jesus got angry when he witnessed exploitation, cheating, taking advantage of the weak, and in this case, in the name of religion, in the very temple of God. It was happening right in the temple. And to the Jews of that day, Jesus' own people, the temple was the very center of the universe. It represented God's presence with God's people, God's covenant with Israel. Jesus saw that it had become something very different than what God had intended. And that is true of so much religious institutionalism. Somehow God gets lost in it all, pushed into the corner. Jesus witnessed how religion had become distorted and exploitative, and it set off a fire in his bosom. And Jesus sprang into action. What he did was a form of social protest, a sort of symbolic act of cleansing the temple, of disrupting it. A disruption to call attention to the wrong that he saw going on under the auspices of official religion. No wonder the temple staff was horrified at what they saw Jesus doing, and they questioned Jesus in anger. They said, "Who gave you the authority to do this?" In other words, who do you think you are stopping the temple business like this? Who gave you the credentials to do that? But Jesus' words were to recall the meaning of the temple and of religious practice. What was it supposed to mean? It is written, "My house will be called a house of prayer for all nations," quoting Isaiah 56:7. "But you have turned it into a hideout for crooks," quoting Jeremiah 7:11. Jesus pushed together two scripture verses, both giving us an idea of not only what the temple was for, but what the abuse was. God's house is a place to commune with God. God's house is a place of prayer, of returning to the center of our being, a holy place and sacred space for us to return to ourselves, to regather our souls. Jesus sought to recover that original purpose and to correct the misuse to which the temple had fallen. Yes, Jesus was angry, but it was not an anger motivated by hate. He did not set out to destroy a person, but to bring awareness that this exploitation, and especially of the poor, of those people who had traveled many miles just to offer their gifts during the festival of Passover, to do it at the temple, that this abuse could not continue unchecked. The writer of the letter of Ephesians put it this way: "Be angry without sinning. Don't let the sun set on your anger." Ephesians 4:26. Yes, Jesus was angry, but he did not sin. His actions stirred up rage in the temple staff, the religious functionaries that profited from what they allowed to go on in the temple. Their anger was different than Jesus' anger. Their anger was motivated by hate and fear that they would lose their positions and their profits. Jesus' actions provoked an intensifying of their desire to destroy Jesus, something that they accomplished in just the next few days when we get to Good Friday. Jesus' symbolic action of disrupting the temple business became the event that kicked the stone, that started the avalanche that swept over Jesus and ended up with his crucifixion on Good Friday. The temple staff revealed their goals in their anger. What was their goals? To destroy. But Jesus' anger, what did it produce? Jesus was in the temple, and the gospel states people who were blind and lame came to Jesus in the temple, and he healed them. Jesus' anger was none other than God's holy wrath burning against sin, and the result was not destruction, but healing, wholeness. People who were excluded were now included in the house of prayer. Even children surrounded Jesus with joy and praise. They weren't afraid of him. Jesus set a model of anger. His actions, though sparked by anger, resulted in healing, not destruction, not violence begetting more violence until we're all caught up in a spiral of greater and greater hostility and never getting over it. Jesus was angry at that which diminishes human life. He saw people excluded, exploited, harmed in the name of religion, and his words and his actions were not done to destroy, but to clear the way for healing and wholeness. Be angry without sinning. Don't let the sun set on your anger. And Jesus practiced this, because our text came to a close with, "Then he left them and went out of the city to Bethany and spent the night there."